I love that picture.
Mm-hmm.
Look at his face, the expression. It's so kind.
Margie McNaughton remembers her father leaving for war. Barely 6 years old when Major John Archibald McNaughton shipped out for England with the North Shore Regiment, Margie still recalls her mother's dread.
My mother always said no person can go through two world wars and survive. As you know, he was through the First World War.
Like many of the men he led, Archie McNaughton was a farmer first, a soldier only by accident of history, a veteran of the Great War he had served and survived. But when conflict erupted again in 1939, Archie signed up in spite of his advanced years.
I mean, he was 43 years old. There was no expectation on the part of the regiment when it was mobilized that an officer of that age would be expected to go overseas, and certainly not to see active service.
But he did. And when the North Shore Regiment stormed ashore at Juno Beach on D-Day, Archie led A Company into the hail of bullets. Their story is retold in this new Heritage Minute, released exclusively to the National.
They were just kids from New Brunswick. Never even left the North Shore before. Dad trained them the best he could. But how could they possibly be prepared?
Heavy on the beach!
He was the prototypical quiet Canadian, you know, didn't make a lot of noise. He just was ready to do whatever it took to push things over. It was a God, king, and country, a deeply religious fellow. But he was, again, to me, symbolic of all of those who just without question went over and risked their lives.
McNaughton's story and that of the North Shore Regiment makes a deep impression at a special screening for students at Fredericton High School.
Seeing someone like him who just, like you said, was a farmer, it just shows how real it was and how serious it was for anyone to join.
And for him to go back, even though he knew exactly how horrible the First World War was, I think that's amazing and so heroic.
Well, my grandfather, Bill Savage, was the personal signaler or radio man for Archie McNaughton. He knew what he was getting into. He knew how bad it was going to be. Yet he owed it to his country, he owed it to the regiment, and he owed it to his boys to see them through. And that to me is like a level of dedication and loyalty to a nation that's beyond incredible.
Dear Grace, there is so much I could tell you. This has been a busy time, but I'm awful glad I was in it.
In his last letter home, written to his wife Grace 2 days before D-Day, Archie expressed few regrets.
Sorry that I wasn't able to give you more of the comforts of life, but it was good fun working together, and it would be so nice to finish things together. This may sound very blue, but I'm feeling rather lonely tonight, and I know what is ahead. I'll tell you someday where I wrote this letter. All of my love to you, and may God take care of you all. As ever, Archie.
Archie McNaughton was killed by enemy gunfire 2 days later. Harry Forrestal, CBC News, Fredericton.